No, no, priority. الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن نبينا ورسولنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وحمل لواه إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I don't know if you want me to talk in English fully or a dual language, English and Arabic. So it will be more interesting for the people who is trying to understand the Arabic to know some of the terminologies of the Arabic in English. And some of the people who is trying to know or to understand the English to know what is the translation of some words in Arabic to English. And maybe we can both, I mean, there will be exchange of ideas sometimes. But in American way, let me first introduce myself to you. Because some of you, they might the first time, or maybe all of you know, but the first time to meet me or to listen to me. I am your brother from Saudi Arabia, general manager of Huda TV. I am a retired general from the Air Force. I studied here in Oklahoma and Texas, my UBT training, under pilot training. I went back to Saudi Arabia. I was in King Faisal Air Academy as a commander there for a while, squadron commander. Then I lifted to study Sharia, Dawah, media. So I took the bachelor, master, and I'm in my PhD. And I worked for 8 years in Africa for relief. We had a committee working for the Muslim needs in Mali, Niger, Chad, Ethiopia, Sudan, Djibouti, Malawi, then Yemen. But I'm specialized in the minority Muslims in Sri Lanka for about 25 years. So we have what we call it AMYS, which is Association of Muslim Youth in Ceylon. And this is, alhamdulillah, we started just minor project. Now we have, alhamdulillah, about 90 mosques, 9 Islamic centers. We are doing, alhamdulillah, the medical aids. We conducted more than 12,000 eye cataract. We did a lot of operations, and we have, alhamdulillah, occasional projects in Ramadan, in Udhiyah, and so on. Alhamdulillah, now we have a big society and association in Sri Lanka. After my retirement, before my retirement, 2 years, regional manager for Peace TV. I am the regional manager, and I am a manager for Huda TV. This TV stations, it is satellite, and it is, alhamdulillah, broadcasting all over the world in many languages. We have English, we have Urdu, we have Bengali, we have Albani, and Chinese now, and Malawi, and Persian, Farsi. Alhamdulillah, we have a chain of TVs. This is, we call it edutainment channels, which is working for the sake of da'wah around the world. Alhamdulillah, the last year we had Peace TV in 10 major cities in United States, but we are broadcasting even Huda TV in website streaming. Last year we had amazing numbers for Huda TV, 73 million hits in 2012, Number one, USA was 20.5 million. Number two, England 7.8. Number three, which is amazing, China 4.7. Then Saudi Arabia, then Canada. This is alhamdulillah the work we are doing. So just I told you, not for anything, just I want you to make dua for everybody is behind this work, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them the reward and guide them to alhamdulillah to the right path. Now I'll come to my subject, and I have a question to you, and I need an answer, not publicly, but inside you. How many of you that he made a lot of dua for the sake of something, but Allah, until yet, he did not reply to him? I'm sure all of us. I am sure you have people, even they are asking sometimes, why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. If my servant asked you about me, I am so near. So you are asking, if he is so near, why is not answering my, replying to my dua? Why I am sick, I'm still sick until now. Why I am poor, I am still poor until now. Why I don't have any job. I am asking him to fulfill my need in jobs, but still. Why my wife, my boy is disobeying me and you. And I'm asking guidance for them. But until yet, oh Lord, you did not reply to my dua. Why? I did what you want me to do. You asked me to do the dua, and I did. You told me to come to the mosque, I did. You told me to wake up in the last third of the night, and I did. But still, my dua was not answered. Not replied. Why? This is a big question. Then Shaitan comes to you and said, okay, this is your Lord. If he is listening to you, if he is really your Lord, he should reply to your dua. Brothers, this is six techniques. Or we can say six conditions. If you fulfill these six needs in your life, believe me, you will have the reply right away. I am coaching in this subject especially because I know it is more sensitive to the people. I know it is a big need for them. Because one word, it will change your life. Listen now. Nuh alayhi salam, when he was one day alone and all this universe against him, he just only said three words.
Inni maghloobun fan.
What does the meaning of maghloob in English? Huh? Maybe defeated, maybe powerless, maybe I cannot do anything. It gives you all the meaning. I lost everything. Inni maghloobun fantasir. Allah said, replied to him right away,
فَفَتَحْنَا أَبْوَابَ السَّمَاءِ بِمَاءٍ مُنْهَمِرٍ وَفَجَّرْنَا الْأَرْضَ عُيُونًا فالتقى الماء على أمر قد قدر وحملناه على ذات ألواح ودسر تجري بأعيننا جزاء لمن كان كفر ولقد تركناها آية فهل من مدكر.
الله. If you know the meaning, if you taste it in Arabic and you know what does mean ففتحنا, what is the mean of the where letter fa after the dua, said ففتحنا fa, he did not say and we did, only fa. Fa mean in Arabic السببية, reasoning. This letter is reasoning, because of his dua we did that, we opened the whole of the sky with water and the springs all over the whole universe, then the water from the sky, springs from the earth got together and a big flood there. Whole universe. He and his believers, how many of them? They said 9, the maximum is 9. From 3 to 9. وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ. Only few, and they said those few, only 9. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this flood because of Nuh and because of his dua. Allah said, وَلَقَدْ تَرَكْنَاهَا آيَةً. We make it as a sign for the people that the dua can does what you don't think of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of his dua. So, believe me, if you implement these 6 conditions, you will change your life. In West Java, I gave this lecture. So, one of the da'is told me, Sheikh, for 17 years, my wife did not get any child. But believe me, last year, I attended the course, and this year, my wife pregnant in her 8 months. This year, I met him in July. He said, Alhamdulillah, I have 2. I told him, why? He said, I implement what you told me. I'm not telling you. Allah told us to do, but we are not fulfilling his orders. We are not fulfilling his, we kind of said, wishes, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to us to do something, desires to us to do some things for our favorite. But we are not fulfilling what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran and the Sunnah. So, number one, remember, always, don't be in hurry looking for the answers. Don't be in hurry looking for the reply. Wait and wait and wait. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُسْتَجَابُ لِأَحَدِكُمْ مَا لَمْ يَعْجَلْ يَقُولْ دَعَوْتُ 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 فَلَمْ يُسْتَجَبْ لِي. What is the meaning of this hadith? Hadith said, almost Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply to your dua unless you become in hurry. Then he will say, why? I made dua, but never Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reply to me. So he said, almost, but there you have to wait. Because it's not you deciding what is good for you. Who decides what is good for you, us, and what is bad? Allah. He's all known. Al-Alim, Al-Khabir. He knew what is good for us now and in the future. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us opportunities to worship him by dua. Believe me, brothers. Allah sometimes put you in trouble because he wants to hear from you, Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. Because he knew that if you are not in trouble, you will not say Ya Rab. So he wants to hear from you. You are a creation, and he wants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hear from you, saying, Ya Rab, oh my Lord, oh my Lord. He loves that. الله يغضب إن تركت سؤاله وبني آدم حين يسأل يغضب. الله, he will be angry if you don't ask him, if you don't make dua to him. But the creation, if you keep asking him, he will be very angry. You might ask me once, twice, third time, but fourth time he said, stop it, ya akhi. Every time you are asking me for something, no, stop there. But Allah, when you keep asking him, when asking him, asking him, he loves that. So he wants to hear from you sometimes. Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. A question. Who is better than you or Musa and Harun? Musa, Nabi. Musa wa Harun, they made the dua, huh? إِنَّكَ آتَيْتَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَأَهُ أَمْوَالًا وَزِينَةً فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا رَبَّنَا لِيُضِلُّوا عَنْ سَبِيلِكَ رَبَّنَا فَطْمِسْ عَلَى أَمْوَالِهِمْ وَاشْدُدْ عَلَى قُلُوبِهِمْ فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى يَرَوُوا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمُ. This is a dua or not? This is a dua or not? This is a dua. فَطْمِسْ عَلَىٰ أَمْوَالِهِمْ وَاشْدُدْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ فَلَا يُؤْمِنُوا حَتَّى يَرَوُوا الْعَذَابَ الْأَلِيمُ. They are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to guide them and to keep them as they are and to destroy all their wealth until they see, because they, Allah subhanahu wa Musa and Fir'aun asking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show them العذاب الأليم. What is the meaning of العذاب الأليم? Punishment, but in another meaning, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants them to be in the critical situation. After 40 years, Allah said, قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ دَعْوَتَكُمَا قَدْ أُجِيبَتْ. Now, he said, Allah said, now I answer and I reply to your da'wah after 40 years. فَاسْتَقِيمَا, be straight, keep the right path. وَلَا تَتَّبِعَانْ سَبِيلَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. And don't follow the people, they are not believers. Don't follow their way. After 40 years. See, Nuh, right away, Musa and Fir'aun, and they are prophets, after 40 years. But we are in hurry. Why we are in hurry? Because everything now you need, just press a button, it is there. Even if you want any info, go to Google it and you get it. If you want any money, go to the ATM machine. You put there, done, then money is coming there. You want to go from here to New York, take any flights. You are there. No more, difficulties. So because we get addicted to that, we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like we deal with creation. So we want to put the dua like we do it in the ATM machine, then the answer will come, reply from there, said, okay, you were asking for so-so, so now we reply to you. No, you're still a creation. And you are dealing with the creator. So don't think that you are dealing with creation like you. You are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he wants you to be like that, it's okay. Don't say no, but believe me, we always think that we need to the end result. Always we are looking for the end results, but not in dua. Because in dua, sometimes you get the end result, but you will not be happy with that. So leave it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is number one. Are we agreeing on this? Should we keep, okay, just we have to do the dua, but the result from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is number one. Number two is a very dangerous condition. And because of that, most of the people came to bust in this condition. You know what I mean, bust? They didn't get the results. They didn't pass the exam, the test. Because of that, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was aware of this. So he, in his time, told us, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ أَوْ لِيُوشِكَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عِقَابًا مِنْهِ ثم تدعونه فلا يستجاب لكم. الله. What is the meaning of this hadith? Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم is swearing, and he swore for me and you, and he is Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. He is the truthful. He is الصادق الصدوق. He does not need to swear to me or to you that he is saying something, but he was trying to emphasize for us. This is a dangerous thing, you have to think of it. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ I swear with whom my soul in his hand that you will join the good and forbid the bad. Otherwise, he will send a punishment from him to you, and you will ask him for, and you will make dua, and he will never reply to you. Because of what? We are not fulfilling. Now, any one of you, if you go outside, you will see a car of your friend with a puncture. You know what? Flat tire? Is that, you call it puncture or flat tire? Flat tire, puncture, whatever. Everybody, of all the people who is seeing that, they will go and, who is car that one? Who is the owner of this car? Yes, please come, your flat tire there. Please don't move, please. Why? Because his one car has a tire and it's flat tire. So we need to tell him that we are good people. Please do and so and repair that. We have people, they have four flat tires in this life. They are very bad Muslims. Very bad, you know, model role for Muslims. And we see them, but we cannot talk to them because they are not driving. They should have a car and drive it, and we tell them, oh, you have a flat tire. Every day we watch Muslims lying, raping, doing so and so. They are our neighbors, they are our relatives. And I said, Alhamdulillah. I don't care. It's not my job. No, it is your job. Al-Muslim, akhul Muslim, la yadlimuhu wa la yahqiruhu. You are his brother. You should tell him the truth. You should make him be a good, not by force. But the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadih. If you can, with your hand, change it. It does not mean you use the force, no. Change it with your hand. Maybe you pay money, maybe you help him in some such things, maybe you take his hand and bring him to the mosque here. Any action you can do with your movement, do it. Otherwise, you use your tongue. Talk to the people, especially Muslims. Go to their houses. Knock at your door, salamu alaikum. I am your brother. Can I have a cup of tea with you? Can we have a little talk? Believe me, you will find difficulties. Because the way to Jannah is not that easy. It's not that easy. But this is the way. This is the way you have to do. How come missionaries come in every house? In every corner you see them with their pamphlets doing all the work. Believe me, when I was in Africa, in different ages, even children, they are there doing da'wah in their own way, for their own religion. This is their rights. Okay? They are proud to do so. We are Muslims, should be, if we don't, at least do that things, we should be ashamed not to talk about the others. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always telling us, if you cannot do it with your tongue, then you do it with what? With your heart. Hate this thing. Hate these things. But in fact, no. If we see something not a good, and we don't change it with that, and we don't change it with tongues, our hearts at least hate that. Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah, he used to see sometimes munkar, bad things, but he cannot change it. What happened? Al-Rawi said, narrator said, then he will yabulu daman. He will peel blood. Be a blood. You know, going to the bathroom? Not urine coming out of him. It's a blood because he is from inside having such a feeling towards his deen. How can I cannot change this? This is the way of the Muslims should be. When you see the Muslims here and there, don't say, oh, very bad. And you come to the mosque and talk about them. And if you spend time talking to them, rather talking about them, we can change. But if we talk about you, not to talk about them, today, Imam of Al-Khatib was saying about what's happening from our left country, Pakistan. He said, one people from Pakistan, or one, two, or three from Pakistan did so and so. Instead of saying, why, what can we do for them? Some people came and said, why this Imam was talking about Pakistan? Why is only pointing on Pakistan? Ya akhi, you are a Muslim. From Pakistan, from Saudi Arabia, from any Muslim, gave an example, a bad example or good example, we should at least, if it is bad, we try to get and to change the bad. If it is good, we try to get and join, the good and make bigger and bigger, investment out of it. But this is our thinking. Why you are talking about me? Why am I talking about you? But why don't you talk about your religion? Why don't you defend your religion? Don't defend only yourself or your family or your country. Defend your religion. This is most important. And I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, now, any one of you, he go and ride or fly with any Muslim airlines, and they have a first class ticket for you, but they put you in Y class, economy class. What you will do? Only complaining? Yo, we will make, a big quarrel about that. Is that right or not? Why? Because they downgraded my ticket, my dunya. But we fly with them and they are serving wines. But they are downgrading my religion. So we don't talk. What can we do? What can we do? If we flow from here, 10 million Muslim on that flight or on that airlines, and everybody of us wrote, we are Muslim, we hate this, please don't do it again,
Otherwise, we will not fly with you.
Aren't they going to change?
Aren't they going to change?
They will change because we made the pressure on them. But we talk about our dunya, but we don't care about deen. So because of this, Allah banish us. Said, you ask for dua, Allah will not reply to you. Okay? This is number two. Number three. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رب أشعث أغبر رافع يديه يقول يا رب يا رب يا رب ومطعمه حرام ومشربه حرام وملبسه حرام وغذي بالحرام أن يستجاب لذاك. Allah, what is this beautiful hadith? Everybody is involved in this hadith. Sayyid sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Rubba ash'atha aghbar, maybe a man coming from abroad with the hair, because if he's, you know the people coming from before, from traveling from abroad, they will come with a huge, bad shape. Ash'atha aghbar rafi'an yutir as-safar. He came from abroad, long trip, long journey. And he is rafi'an radiyah. He is making like that and making dua. Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Rab. You know why? Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-musafir, his dua is replied. Dua al-musafir mustajab. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioning that this guy, he is fulfilling that. He is musafir and he is coming from abroad from long journey and he is making dua, but his food, haram. His income, haram. His drinks is haram. His thoughts, what he غذية بالحرام, what he is taking from different channels here and there is haram. Rasulullah said, how come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply to this? See how many people they are taking interest. Riba. Is it easy to do so? What is the percentages? Point five. Whatever you take, it is haram. Harmun lillahi wa rasulah. So what can I do? Live as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to live. He tested you. He wants to see, are you patient? He wants to see, are we going to get together and make our own bank? Make our own fund and get together and help here and there? Get together and you borrow me and I borrow from you? But the problem, no. We don't care. We want to ride a car. We want to rent a house. We want to do and so and so. Halal, haram, we don't think. Under the table, above the table, from there, from here, smuggling, whatever. Just bring me money. Al-halal, what is coming in my pocket. Al-haram, what is going to your pocket. This is the thinking of the people a days. Any money comes to my pocket, it is halal. Whatever the source it's coming from. Any money coming to your pocket, it's haram. Because I can, judge you, but you don't have to judge me. ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون. Everything is haram. Now, anyone can go, eat anything. He does not care. أخي, whatever. Eat whatever. No. Try to find the halal thing. Because as much as you put in your mouth, or mother, or wife, or son, or daughter, halal, this will help you and help them in replying to their dua. In time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was proud of his uncle Sa'd, Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas. He is the brother of his sister. His mother. So Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, Ya Rasulullah, said, yes, uncle. Yes, Saad, what do you want? He said, I want from you a wish, one wish only. He said, okay, go ahead. What do you want? He said, I want any dua I make it, Allah will reply to me. Only any da'wah. He said, okay. It is for you and for the others. أطب مطعمك تكون مستجاب الدعوة. أطب مطعمك يا سعد يا جمعان يا محمد يا سعيد يا عبد الرحمن يا anyone. أطب مطعمك, make your income حلال, make your food حلال, الله سبحانه وتعالى will reply to you. So this is very important. See how many, how is the ways now people drinking, drugging, doing all the things, and he comes here, that's it, and he's going. Ya akhi, he said, Allah, alhamdulillah, I made dua. Allah, even sometimes he said, ya sheikh, make dua for me that my Allah give me children. He said, did you get married? He said, no, how can I get you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you children if you don't get married. If you don't do the reason for that, if you don't make yourself going in the straight path, how can I make dua for you without you are quitting drinking, quitting drugs, quitting smoking, quitting going out with girls? How can Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will lead me and lead you? You have to do step number one from your side. Quit. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take you. So he said, أطب مطعمك. Don't eat something haram. It does not mean eat by eating, but any income, anything comes to your bucket or comes to your house or comes to your wealth, make sure it is not haram. Third, fourth, very important, especially here with multinational Muslims here. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, تعرض الأعمال على الله في كل يوم اثنين وخميس. All the deeds will be explored to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Monday and Thursday. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive anyone except people he has, people though they have a quarrel or they have, you know, miss, what can we say? Shahna. What does the meaning of shahna? Argument or something between each others, between their, not a conflict, it's something misunderstanding, you can say, or argument, or some kind of enmity between each other, then you have to clear your chest to have a good heart towards the others. I hate you because you are black. He said, I hate you because you are a Pakistani. I hate you because you are a Saudi. I hate you because you are a Somali. I hate you because you are so and so. And everyone is downgrading the others, and we are all Muslims. We are praying to the same Lord, same mosque, listening to same Jum'ah, and after we come out of the mosque, we start, you know, cursing each other. How come? Or backbiting. We keep backbiting the imam, the friend, the neighbor, anyone. Just, it is, this is our, you know, hobby. This is what make us feel relaxed when we talk about you, about him, about anyone. You are Muslims. And you are, since you are Muslims, you should be brothers. If you are brothers, you know what the meaning of the brotherhood? The meaning, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he brought Muhajirin and Ansar, they divided their houses, their food, their wealth, their women, and they felt like they are, I mean, one family. In 82, I was in, or 83, I was in Dallas. Bilal was a black Muslim, new Muslim. Jordanian brother, he was working in one of the hospitals as administrator. So his family called him from abroad, from Jordan, said, "We have for you a slot. Come right now. Come as, you know, CEO of one of the hospitals there, big hospitals in Jordan, Amman." So he sold all his goods. He quit his job from the hospital in Dallas, and he went to Chicago. When he reached to Chicago, they told him, "Oh, already somebody took your slot." Subhanallah. This is a big test. So he came back to Dallas again. He was willing to work in Jordan, but he cannot suffer and go to Jordan. Then it is hard for him to go back to United States. So he said, "I'll go back from Chicago to back to Dallas. I was there." So when he came back to the hospital said, "Oh, sorry. We gave your slot to somebody else." So the post was in, some American came and took that post. So he was jobless. Some of the Saudis and Arabs and, you know, they gathered for him some money and gave it to him. But one day, two, three, four, you know what happened? I went to the house myself. House of Bilal. Bilal was working in the post office, distributing letters in the late night. So he told him, "Muhammad," he said, "Yes." He said, "I don't have money to give you, but I can divide my house in two. Half of it to you and half for me. But I will kick my two non-Muslims sons to bring you in, you and your family." I went to their house. They divided the house with sheets, and he has half of it, and the other brother has the other half. And he said, "What I get, what I earn from the post office, I'll give you half until you get your job. This is what I can do. And take my car in the morning, go find your job, and in the late night, I'll take that, you know, car to go and distribute the mail I have." This is real brotherhood. He's a new Muslim, but he tasted the Islam. He was in Jahiliyyah before, so he knew the Islam. But because we born Muslim, and we live among the Muslims, and all of us are Muslims, and we had a quarrel when we were, you know, young with other Muslims. So this big, small quarrel, it big, you know, it was built with us a big imagination until we are now 50s and 40s and 30s. But you are Muslims. Remember, if you be good to your brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hereafter, يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, المتحابون في الله على منابر من نور يغبطهم النبيون والشهداء. The people who have loved in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be in chairs from light, from nur. And this chairs, even the prophets and the shuhada, يغبطونهم. They said, "Oh, what is this?" Because why? They got their places in Jannah before the day of judgment. Already they have their place. But the shuhada and al-anbiya still under al-arsh, but this already have their own place. They reserved, alhamdulillah, their seats. And this is all Muslim who has the right brotherhood with his other brother. That in the hereafter. But in this life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reply to you. Especially if you make dua for me, I am an absent. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul, dua al-Muslim li-akhihi al-Muslim, mustajabun bi-dhahr al-ghayb. Mustajab, walahu malak. There is a malak. There is an angel saying, and you will be rewarded as same as him. وَلَكَ بِالْمِثْلِ. This is fourth thing. Fifth thing, continuation. That one, don't be in hurry, but continue. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن الله يحب العبد الملحاح. Who is always. ويقول صلى الله عليه وسلم من سره أن يستجيب الله له في الرخاء في الشدة فليكثر من الدعاء في الرخاء. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reply to you in your If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reply to you in your need, the time of your need, then be in the time of relaxation, time of there is no need, more making dua to Allah. Because most of us, they are making dua when we are, what? An exam, looking for a job, we are sick, traveling in the airplane, but when you go down, everything changed. We think that we will not die unless we fly. And we think we will not die until we are sick. We think we will not die until we are, you know, in a bad situation. No. In our military hospital, there one guy, he went to the doctor and he was making a blood test. So after he results came to him, the doctor told him, Oh, sorry. He said, what? I said, Ya Akhi, you have a cancer in your blood. He said, what? This is the results. Listen, I'm going to give you 2 weeks treatment and go home. After 2 weeks, you come back again for another blood test. But this is your... The man who said, Oh, la ilaha illallah, ya Allah, ya Allah. He quit smoking, he left his beard, he keep praying all time, you know, keep fasting, making dua, Imam, please make dua, please make dua. I am sick, I am sick. After 10 days, they called him, come, please. The doctor told him, say, Oh, listen, we are very sorry to tell you that we mistaken in the serial number. That was same number because in the air, but is it Allah, ya, please give me a cigarette. 2 weeks I didn't smoke anything. How come you destroy my life? How come, ya, akhi? This guy think that he said, but what? Doctor said, ya, akhi, mashallah, light in your face. He said, ya, akhi, light in my face. You don't know inside me. You killed me, man. This is the nature of the people. One of my friends, he said, we were flying from one country to, from one city to another one. So this guy, he has a deed for one land. This land, it was not for him, but he's a big enough, old enough, that he is very happy that land came, the judge gave it to, in his name. So he was looking to the deed. He said, while he's looking, then a big turbulence came. So the pilot said, please, captain, said, please sit down, even the crew, because we are suffering a very huge, turbulence. So please sit down, fasten your seat belt until we get through. My friend, he's a pilot from Air Force. He said, this guy, or this man, old man, he stand up. I said, please, I will tell you the truth. This deed is not for me. So please witness that I am giving back the land to the man who is the real owner. He said, you are witnessing us. What? Maybe we die with you. Please sit down now. He said, no, I want you to witness before I die. He said, ya, akhi, sit down now. No, he was standing up. He said, no, this I want to just... make you as a witness that this land is not for me. So he said, we were very happy. So when we landed, we came to him and said, Sheikh, he said, yes. He said, the land. He said, no, it's mine. Anyone claiming that he has to take the airplane, go to Riyadh again. Because he's thinking if anyone fly to by the airplane will have disturbance, he might die. How come the people keep in their minds that if you get things, only make dua when you are in a big need? No. Inna Allah yuhibbu al-abd al-milhah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he loves that you keep making dua for him. So this is number 5. Number 6, and last. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله لا يقبل دعاء من قلب غافل الله. Allah would not reply to the heart who's away there. غافل الله is only playing, is not making dua like we are doing now after each salah. I said, ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة. How come? Are you? You are answering the phone, talking to the man, and making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. We should know to whom we talk. Imam Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, when the Adhan came, his face will be changed to a reddish face. Told him, Imam, why your face is changing? Said, oh, you don't know in front of whom I'm gonna stand up now? I am going to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I should be reddish. Every one of us, when you come to salah, you know that you're going to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will talk to you. When he said, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, he said, Hamidani Abdi, my servant, he praised me. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, he said, Athna Alayya Abdi, that again Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ar-Rahman Malik Yawmuddin, this is between me and my servant. Ihdina As-Sirat Al-Mustaqim, this is for my servant, and whatever he asks, I will give. He talked to you, but he listen, he talked to us, and we are not there. Sheikh Aid al-Qarni, maybe some of you heard of him. He's the author of Kitab La Tahzan, Don't Be Sad. He said, we were to one of the villages from Abha going to Mecca. And with us, one Egyptian, mashallah, he is good memorized in the Quran, and he is good in recitation. So he said, we went to one of the villages. So the Imam was reading Al-Fatiha, but he's not reading right Fatiha. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Rahman Rahim, Waladdallin. So this guy was so anxious. So he said, Waladdallin. So the Imam said, Ameen. Because we are already automatically programmed on saying after Walad Dallin, Ameen. We are not there. Believe me, brothers and sisters. A friend of mine, he said in Ramadan time, they were looking for somebody to lead the Salah. So they put me in because they said, okay, I have a little beard. So they put me, and he said, I cannot control myself. I didn't know what to do. And when comes the salah, it's okay. But when comes the dua, I couldn't make it. So I said, Allahumma a'izz al-shirka wal-mushrikeen. They said, Ameen. Allahumma adhill al-islam wal-muslimin. They said, Ameen. So I said, I said, Allahumma a'izz al-islam wal-muslimin. They said, Ameen. Allahumma adhill al-shirka wal-mushrikeen. I said, Ameen. Then after I finished my from my salah, I said, why didn't you correct me? I was mistaken. They said, we don't know. You prayed for us or for against us. But it is salah. Yes. This is the problem, brothers and sisters. We are not concentrating a lot in our dua. So these six things, again, first, dumbi, hari, amr bil ma'ruf ni'al munkar, joining the good, forbidding the bad. Third, looking for the right halal income, halal food, halal, wealth. Fourth, you have a good heart. Fifth, always in good situation, bad situation, be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the last and not the least is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Allah la yastajibu du'a min qalbin ghafilillah. Believe me, Aisha said, radiallahu anha, I knew when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied to my dua. I knew the time that this is a time of rebellion, when my heart starts shaking, my tears coming down, I feel I am in a situation that I am like I'm flying. And every one of you has this, had this sensation one day. And you will have it. Sometimes you feel you are alone, making dua, start tearing, start, you know, just frustrating. This is the time you make a good dua, concentrate in that time. Don't think of anything more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Believe me, when you do two rak'ahs, you don't think of anything. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guaranteed for you al-jannah. Who prays two rak'ah without putting in his mind anything, you will enter the jannah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. Okay. Now we come to the end. If you implement this sixth thing, okay, how can I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reply to me or not? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ما من مسلم يدعو بدعوة ليس فيها إثم ولا قطيعة رحم إلا آتاه الله بها واحدة من ثلاث. Not any Muslim make dua. There is not, what can we call it? قطيعة الرحم. I don't know what is in English. But there is, between you and your relative, what we tell, قطيعة الرحم. Not misunderstanding. Not to get in touch with them. You don't have any relation with them and they are your relative. Or something, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that it is against them or against anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you three choices. Three ways of replying to your dua. First, you will get it right away. And believe me, sometimes maybe you said, Allahumma ghafir lana. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your sins in that majlis, in that session. Like now, Allahumma ghafir lana. اللهم ارحمنا اللهم تقبلنا اللهم اعتق رقابنا مايت الله سبحانه وتعالى get that as you know as quick as we think. Second, أو يصرف عنه من السوء. He will not reply to your dua, but he will take you away from something gonna happen to you, so Allah سبحانه وتعالى will take it, detour you to something else. You will not something else. For example, you are asking for your children to be in the medical school, but he will not be, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prevented him from being with that society. Maybe he will mislead it and he took over something else, business, piloting, you know, anywhere else that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will give him more wealth, more hidayah. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guidance. Or he will keep it for you in the day of, in the last day. In the last day, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the people see that the dua they made, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard it, but did not reply it, everyone in his life, that he wishes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never reply to him, because he will reward him more than he think of in this hayah. In this life. So as-sahaba said, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rasulullah, we will make more dua. He said, if you make more dua, Allah will make more ajr to you and more deeds. Allahumma la asaluka bi asma'ika al-husna wa sifatika al-ula wa bi ismika al-a'lam al-a'zam alladhi idha du'ita bihi ajabta wa idha su'ilta bihi a'tayt an taghfir junubana ajma'in. Allahumma aghfir junubana ajma'in. اللهم اغفر ذنوبنا أجمعين. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت وتولنا في من توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت واصرف عنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا. اللهم ارحمنا واغفر لنا. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تصلحنا وتصلح أولادنا. اللهم اصلحنا وأصلح أولادنا وإخواننا وأخواتنا وجيراننا والحاضرين والحاضرات والسامعين والسامعات. اللهم أعز دينك وانصر كلمتك وانصر عبادك فوق كل أرض وتحت كل سماء. اللهم اغفر لنا أجمعين وهب المسيئين منا للمحسنين. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم رد المسلمين إليك ردا جميلا. اللهم رد المسلمين إليك ردا جميلا. اللهم اصلحنا أجمعين. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا. اجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، والموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم إنا عبيدك بنو عبيدك بنو إمائك، نواصينا بيدك ماض فينا حكمك، عدل فينا قضاؤك. نسألك اللهم بكل اسم هو لك سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك، أن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وذهاب أحزاننا وجلاء همومنا وغمومنا. اللهم ردنا إلى أهلنا سالمين غانمين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين. اللهم لا توفانا إلا وأنت راض عنا. اختم بالصالحات آجالنا، اغفر ذنوبنا وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تؤتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد وعلى أصحاب محمد وأزواج محمد. اللهم صل عليهم صلاة دائمة من قطع دام الليل والنهار. اللهم صل عليهم يا رب العالمين مداد الكلمات والأشجار والأنهار يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. وصلى اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد.